has for most of the knockout. If you score the first try and scores are level at the end of the clash, well, that first try means you're the side to progress through to the next round. And as the name of the tournament suggests, this is knockout football. And the quarterfinals will be going from 8 teams to a final 4 playing tomorrow morning. Let's see who can play into Monday. And Blacktown coming away with it here through their 5-8, getting it back there to the number 9, Maurice Trindle. This is an opportunity for them. Jared Samet, the 6 for Blacktown, with the intercept there. Let's see what they can do. 3 metres away from the line, but the ball pops loose. And it is play on, says our official. And Newcastle, well, lucky to get away without conceding there.
Yeah, a little panic there from Blacktown. They had an opportunity to build some pressure. Relieve it, let the ball go on the second tackle. And now NAB get a penalty, come out of their own half.
The winner of this clash taking on the victor of Walgett Aboriginal Connection, taking on Tweed Connections. That game on right now on one of the other fields here at Tuggerah. But we've got the best part of 40 minutes of football to play before we can determine that. And it is the Newcastle All Blacks showing inside and going himself. It looks like it might be Smith and putting away Matt Simon in the corner. The Newcastle All Blacks fans are happy. The hosts of the tournament are in and they are 4 to the good.
And then when he showed inside, just had too much time, got around his defender. And then just waits for his winger to pop up in the outside. But it was all Will Smith. He orchestrated that try.
Had a mountain of work in these early stages, first 8 minutes of this round 4 knockout clash. 4-0 the score in favour of the reigning champions, the Newcastle All Blacks, looking to make it to a Monday yet again. But Blacktown, well, they still might have something to say about that. Jermaine McEwen will play the football in front of the uprights, 22 away from the stripe, and a dinking kick over the top proves to be more of a challenge than the Newcastle All Blacks would have liked, and they've earned themselves a goal line dropout here at Blacktown.
Yeah, good little kick into the wind. Here's the big hit we've seen on screen. There's been a few of them over the weekend. That time it was Piper.
Right in front of the uprights, 30 metres away, plays the football, goes for a smart scoot to collect another 10, and cramps are setting in there for one of the Blacktown players, stretching and leaving his defensive line one short. Can Newcastle make the most of it? They almost did, with Matt Simon popping the pass back on the inside for Cuban Piper, but Piper can't pick it up, and it goes again over this commentary side touchline. Aaron Simon takes it within 25 of the line. And Sumner, well, he finds Will Smith, and Smith sends it out wide, but coming up with it, the Blacktown Red Belly Warriors. It's nothing but a foot race now. Does he have the speed, the fullback? He does, and Donovan Boney, he's going to score their first try for the Blacktown Red Belly Warriors. The bench is up, the team is up, and they have 4 points to their name. They're back in it.
But again, Smith heading across field. The pass just a little high. Boney takes the intercept, has the speed. Smith chased in vain. Blacktown now 4-all.
And this is by no means a fait accompli, but looks good off the boot and gets the extras. They'll be relieved about that. And finally plays the football. Stepping back on the inside is Chris Piper. They're locked forward and going within a few metres of the line for the last. Which way do they go here? And they go to the left and grubbering through the slightest of holes, but closing it is Tyron Pettit-Young for the Blacktown Red Belly Warriors.
Yeah, that could be one of the biggest plays of the game so far, covering the kick there from Smith. They're now on the attack. I was surprised the markers were square. They weren't. And things are starting to compound here for the Newcastle All Blacks. The Blacktown team are well on top. It was just a simple dummy half run. Didn't seem to be onside. They decided not to go for the kick because the wind's so strong.
Couple of tackles up their sleeve, but only 2 minutes on the clock. and he tries to evade the defender, gets past one there, does Lincoln Smith, pops a pass away, gets back to Briggs. Briggs gets a pass away, but the play doesn't go any further than that, right in front of the uprights. 13 metres out, Will Smith with the ball. The characteristic dinking kick of his that gets into the in-goal area.
Grounded goal one. It's a goal one, mate.
But it is saved at the back there by the Blacktown Red Belly Warriors. We'll have a line goal dropout, but that for them is a result they'll take.
It was a great kick. Compete for the ball. He grounds the ball. They've had a head clash. I don't think they're going to get these players off the field before the time elapses here. They're both down on the field. This could be the end of the game. We see him come in. Oh, there's a head clash and his head's hit the ground. The Hooter goes. It'll be full time. On the clock's 5:04. You can count it down. Do we hear the siren?
Will we have the goal line drop out? No, we will not. That is it. And some disappointing scenes to end this clash with the tensions that have been building up for much of the day. Boiling over before huge celebrations amongst the Blacktown Red Belly Warriors fans. They made it to a semi-final at the knockout, and that for them is huge.